And so the teacher wants me to give a presentation about a sports person, and I don't know who to talk about.
Well, I've got an idea. Do you want to hear it?
Absolutely.
OK. Talk about Hermann Meyer.
The skier?
Yes.
Tell me about him.
OK. Well, he's Austrian, and like most Austrian boys, he liked skiing, and he wasn't bad at it. He went to a special skiing school when he was 15, but the teachers at the school said he was too small and told him to go home.
Oh.
So he went back home, and for a time he worked as a bricklayer. You know, helping to build walls and houses and things.
So he stopped skiing?
No, he didn't. He still wanted to be a good skier, so he kept practicing. And then he won a couple of small races. And in 1996, he got into the Austrian team.
Right.
He won several World Cup races. But in 1998, he fell really badly. At more than 100 kilometres per hour at the Olympic Games in Japan.
Ouch!
Yeah. But 3 days later, he was back. And he won the Olympic gold medal in the super giant slalom. Only 3 days later.
Wow! Brilliant! OK, Dad. Thanks. That's a really good...
Whoa, wait. There's more.
Oh, sorry.
Here's the best bit. 3 years later, 2001, I think it was, Meyer was on his motorbike when a car hit him. It was a really bad accident, and the doctors operated on him for hours. He nearly lost one of his legs.
Wow.
And they had to put metal in his legs and everything. And the doctors said, "No more skiing. You'll never ski again. You'll be lucky if you walk properly." But he went back to skiing. And in 2004, he won the World Cup. Isn't that amazing?
Oh, it is. I can use this. Thanks, Dad. I think I've got my presentation now.
Happy New Year, Dad.
Happy New Year. Let's hope it brings us lots of luck, eh?
Yes, Dad. What are your resolutions this year?
Resolutions? Well, I'm not going to eat unhealthy food anymore. I'm going to give up eating chips, for one thing. And I'm going to make an effort to get fitter. Mum and I are going to check out that new gym.
Both those resolutions sound familiar, Dad. They're the same as the ones you made last year.
Yes, well, this year I really mean it. You can tell me off if I don't keep them this time. Anyway, what about your resolutions?
Well, first of all, I'm going to take up running. And, listen to this, I'm going to tidy my room every weekend.
That's not going to be easy.
And Jodie and I are going to set up a business.
A business? Amy, you're only 16.
I know, Dad, but we can earn some money by walking people's dogs for them. We looked it up on the internet. It's going to be a great success.
Ah, so are you going to take our dog for a walk now so that I don't have to do it every day?
Well, Dad, it'll cost you, but you don't have to pay the full price because you're family. I'm sure we can work something out.
Mom, Dad, we're going now, okay? Okay, you two. Have a good time. But remember...
Yes, Mum. We know.
You must be home at 12:30.
You can stay at the party for the midnight celebration, but you mustn't stay longer than that.
Okay, no problem.
It isn't far, so we're going to leave at 12:15 and walk back. We'll be home at 12:30.
Fine. Have you got your mobile phones?
Oh, yes, you mustn't forget those.
We've got mine. Ashley lost his last week, remember?
Okay. Call us if there's any problem, okay?
We will. Promise.
Okay. Off you go. Have a good time.
Thanks. See you later. I mean, at 12:30.
Look at the time. It's 2:15 in the morning. And the police are bringing you home.
Mum, Dad, we can explain.
What on earth happened?
Well, we left the party at 12:15, like we said.
And on the way home, we saw an accident.
There was a woman on a bicycle and a car hit her.
But the car didn't stop and the woman was hurt.
So we called an ambulance and we waited until it came.
We couldn't leave her. We had to wait with her.
And the police came too. And they asked us some questions. And then they brought us home.
But isn't your phone working? Why didn't you answer the phone? Why didn't you phone us? You promised.
I tried to, Mum, but my battery was flat.
Well, why didn't you ask the police to call us?
Oh, I never thought of that, Dad. Actually, we were very upset, you know.
Yes, of course. Sorry. Is the woman okay?
Yes, she is. And she thanked us for our help. She says she's going to take us all out for a meal when she's better.
Welcome to Two Great Minds. With me in the studio are Claudia and Tony. A minute ago, we showed them three pictures and asked them to think about the question, how brave do you think these people are? Tony, you start.
Okay, Claudia. What about this picture? What score did you give her?
I gave her 2. She knows what she's doing and she's good with animals. I don't think she has to be that brave.
But some dogs are really dangerous. Look at those teeth.
I'm not sure. How many points did you give her?
4.
Okay, we don't agree here. No big deal.
What did you give the next picture?
Well, he has to be very brave. Look how high up he is. I can't imagine going up there on my own in that little lift. It's just a rope, really. If it breaks, he'll fall and die. I gave him 5. What about you?
I only gave him 3.
Really? Why?
Well, if he stays in the lift, there's no danger. I think it looks more dangerous than it really is. Yeah, 3 points. So what about the third picture? I gave her 3.
Yeah, me too. These modern X-ray machines aren't really dangerous anymore. They won't make her ill if she's careful.
That's right.
So, we both agree on 3 for her.
Yeah.
Good. Okay, thanks. Well, as usual, we also want to know what you people think. So please, have a look at the photos. You can find them on our website, www.twogreatminds.co.uk.